And to give us an overview of the subject, please welcome Alexandre Guignard.
Hi, Paul. What we want to share with you now is how we take care of our customer with our global ecosystem management to remove any worries and do it in a sustainable way. The first concern is the charging. We want to make it easy with the best customer experiences, easy private charging, easy public charging for B2C and for B2B usages. The second question is the battery life cycle. We want to manage the whole battery life cycle in a full circular economy strategy. It means a battery lifespan for automotive use. It means the second life of the batteries, and at the end, the recycling. And last but not the least, in our chaotic world, we want to guarantee the availability of our EV products for our customers. It means securing the batteries and the raw material supply. So let's see together how we're going to manage those priorities.
Thank you, Alexandre, and we'll see you later to talk about battery reuse. Absolutely. Thank you. So, one of the major concerns we have mentioned for our customers is charging. So, here to tell us about charging services, please welcome Brigitte Corteroux. Hi, Brigitte.
Hi, Paul. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, thanks.
So, I think we're going to have to start with the main pain point for customers. I realize that during this transition phase, you know, things are changing very quickly, but still, the main or one of the main pain points for customers is charging. So how does Stellantis hope to tackle this issue?
You know, Paul, that we are developing a strong strategy to support our customers. We are here for our customers. So we offer a 360 degrees offer for both our private and B2B customers. So it's an end-to-end customer providing wall box installation, charging stations. And on top of that, we provide a day-to-day smart charging offer, which is a bundle. As a customer, when you want to buy an EV car, you also have a bundle of a wall box, the installation, the home green energy, and the charging solution when you are out of home. And it's a peace of mind for the customer.
But is it something that you buy as a bundle, or can you customize it? Can you change things?
In fact, we customize some of our solution. For instance, when our customers need us to tailor-made some solution, we are there for them. So we partnership with third parties. For the example, we have done one partnership between Jeep and Electrify America with solar charging station in America.
I saw that photo. It's very impressive.
What I mean. Yeah. You know,
cars are coming through and solar charging.
Yeah. It's wonderful. Huh?
Yeah. I'm thinking about the future because I can see that you're answering customer needs for today, but what kind of new technologies are coming up that are going to answer future needs?
Yeah, we want to be at the cutting edge of the future of the smart grid. So we innovate in VGI technology. Why? In order to really well integrate EV cars into the smart grid. So we already have a pilot in Italy. We are also doing agreements, and we have done agreements with big B2B customers in order to start by 2022 in the field those kind of solution. But more than that, we also intend to launch the largest fast charging network in South Europe first, and we will deploy the rest of Europe after. And what do we do? In fact, we are partnering with NGOPS. You know, NGOPS is one of our big partners. So as free-to-movie solution, we design, produce, and deliver the fast charging, and NGOPS will develop the network and invest in the network. Nice. This is new. And this is also, on top of that, we also, with those fast charging stations, it's new, it's a world premiere. This is with storage energy, and it's plugged with the grid. So smart grid will be there also.
I think there could be a lot of people very interested in that. But it's in Southern Europe, right? So that's where it's going to start. And what's the strategy for geographical development after that?
All our solutions, so we have started all our solution, our 360 degree solution in Europe. And we intend to launch in Americas, in North America first, and in Latin America.
Great. Well, thank you very much, Brigitte.
Thank you, Paul.
So we're now going to move on to another subject and take a quick dive into something that I think people haven't thought enough about, which is battery reuse and battery repair. So please welcome Alexandre Guignard.
Let's see now the battery life cycle. Our strategy is to manage a sustainable battery life cycle within a global circular economy strategy. Our first concern is to ensure the customer satisfaction. The battery must last as long as the vehicle lifespan and beyond the guarantee period. And to do that, we are able to monitor by software management the state of health of a battery, and if necessary, to provide a unique services to our customer to maintain the performance above 70%, thanks to the e-repair center in each and every country where we operate, 21 centers up and running by end of the year, including Japan and Korea, and for deeper or longer operation, what we call remanufacturing, we have the battery expertise center. The first one is operating in Rüsselsheim. It's scalable and replicable. Then when the battery level of performance is not sufficient anymore for vehicle usage, the battery can be reused for a second life as energy storage capacity. Our GV, Free2Move eSolution, is a dedicated entity to commercialize different kinds of products based on second life as e-mobility charging station or third-party storage, for instance, buildings and condominium. The repurposing is integrated in our battery expertise centers. And ultimately, once batteries are no more suitable anymore for automotive or for second life, they are recycled with qualified partners. But with the volume growth, 100 batteries per year today, 5,000 by 24, and above 500,000 by 2035 for Europe only, and with a new recycling technology for raw material extraction, between 90 to 99% recycling of different raw materials, we are gonna integrate the recycling through a new partnership in our Stellantis footprint in Europe, then in North America. The extracted raw materials will be used to remanufacture new batteries and close the loop of battery life cycle and reduce deeply the cost, logistic, valorization of raw materials. That battery life cycle management is the core of our circular economy business model and contributes to the sustainability of our EV products.
Thank you very much, Alexander. So now we're going to see how that remanufacturing works out in practice at the Battery Expertise Center in Rüsselsheim. Video. So thank you, Alexander, and thank you, Rüsselsheim, the research center there. As Alexander mentioned, mastering the battery life cycle is also about supply chain continuity and access to raw materials. So please welcome Michelle Wen. Hi, Michelle.
Hi, Paul.
So the first question is really about your strategy in terms of, from a purchasing standpoint, in terms of securing battery availability in order to meet your customers' demands.
Well, I propose that we first have a look at the medium-term horizon. From a purchasing strategy standpoint, Stellantis is applying a multi-sourcing strategy at platform and module technology level. By doing so, we are making sure we guarantee the best competitiveness and the total landed cost and higher agility to react to the flexible customer demands. In 2025, we will contract a minimum 130 gigawatt hour, of which 80 gigawatt hour for European needs through our ACC joint ventures investments in Douvrin, SOP plant in 2023, and in Kaiserslautern, SOP plant in 2025, as well as thanks to our best Asian battery partners, such as CATL, BYD, Svolt, Samsung, and LG. In North America, we will secure 50 gigawatt hour in partnership with a major battery partner, which with whom we are in final step of contracting. And so in total of three gigafactories established in Europe and North America.
So moving forward, what would be your outlook for 2030?
Well, now looking into 2030, our customer demand will represent a minimum 20 times more gigawatt hour compared to 2021. Our strategic direction is to secure a minimum of 260 gigawatt hour of capacities. This means that in 2030 in North America, a minimum of 90 gigawatt hour available capacities through the continuation of our partnership, which we have already established in 2025, and also potentially a second partnership, including the possibility of establishing an ACC plant in North America. And in Europe, a minimum of 170 gigawatt hour available capacities through extended collaboration with ACC, minimum 50% of our needs targeted in 2030, to be expanded by increasing size of production blocks and by establishing a new plant, for example, in Italy, and on top of the existing two gigafactories, Douvrin and Kaiserslautern, which will already be operating in 2025. And the sourcing partnerships with our best Asian suppliers, including localizing their production in Europe. So at the end of the day, this means a minimum of 5 gigafactories established in Europe and in North America. So you can see that we have a clear strategic direction for 2025, and for 2030, we could summarize in one slide.
Oh, well, I love it when we summarize everything all on one slide, because you can see in one glance a very clear roadmap for the future. So thank you, Michelle. But what about the raw materials that are used to manufacture the high voltage batteries, which is another key issue? What's your strategy to secure them?
You are right. We don't just stop there. Not only we are guaranteeing our customer demands growth through capacity investment, but we are also securing at our raw material availability and sustainability. In particular, we have identified lithium as the most critical raw material with regards to availability, and we have taken 2 upstream value chain initiatives by signing 2 MOUs for new direct offtake of lithium with lithium geothermal partners in North America and in Europe. And indeed, our tier one battery suppliers have also contracted the raw material supply in Europe. On the longer term, Stellantis also prepares to set up offtake agreements of recycled raw material with raw material recyclers. As I have mentioned, the importance of sustainability for Stellantis, and after having audited our current suppliers with regards to the cobalt supply, we are extending our partnership with third-party external agency to run the same evaluation on lithium, nickel, and the graphite.
Wow. Well, thank you very much, Michelle. Very clear. Thank you.
Thank you.
So now we get to the part where you investors and financial analysts and media have all been waiting for, the financials.